Hi everybody, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Today I have 10 different tips to help manage your email in the new Microsoft Outlook. These 10 tips will help you keep everything organized and clean so you're not overwhelmed with all your emails. Then at the end, I'm going to throw in some extra bonus material, so make sure that you're getting the most out of all the features in the new Microsoft Outlook. I just want to make sure that you're in the new Microsoft Outlook. So if you take a look in the top right-hand corner, you can see how I have this toggled on. Now, if it's completely new to you, the new Microsoft Outlook, I do have a tutorial on it that I'll place up above in the card, and down below, I'll put a link in the description as well. Make sure you go through these 10 tips, and if you're interested, take a look at that video. Let's start with pinning emails. If I go up to this message and just hover over it, notice that I have the pin right here. Now, pinning emails is a really great feature. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this and notice it goes to the top. So let's say I'm going through my emails in the morning and there's a couple of emails that I need to maybe work on later. I could flag them, and I'll talk about flags in another tip in just a moment. But the nice part with this, if you receive any more emails, this pinned one will stay on top. So notice a new email just came in. The pinned one stays right there. Flagged ones won't stay on top. Now I can go ahead and turn this off very quickly just by unpinning, and we'll put it back where it belongs. Tip number two is to flag an email. So I just showed you the pin, but if we go ahead and hit flag, this will show up in your to-do list. Now you can get to your to-do list very quickly by just going over to here to the left and just click on to-do. To-do opens up, and notice if I go to flagged email, I have it right here. Now, then I would have a list of different things that throughout the day that I would know I would have to do. Now, the other thing is, as soon as I turn it off like so, it will disappear from the to-do list. Tip number three is to use My Day. Now, if I look up top here, I'm going to go ahead and click on this. You can see it says My Day. As soon as it opens up this panel down this side here, I'm just going to go ahead and take this email. I can drag it right on. I now notice I can add it as a task on the calendar, or I can add it as an event. As soon as I drop it, it will come up with more specifications of what I want about this meeting. So I'm just going to hit dismiss all on this, but now I can go through and set things and invite people to this if I want. So it gives a quick way to add a calendar event. The other thing is, I'm going to discard this, you can quickly add this to-do also. So if I move over to-do, and now I drag it over here, you can see it will be added to the list just like I showed you before. And if we go up top here, we can open to-do from here, or if I go to the calendar, we can open to-do from here also. Now it's time to give a bonus tip. And for this, I'm going to move over to the calendar. If you're new to the calendar, I do have a tutorial for this that I'll put up above in the card, so you can click on it and learn more about this. And I'll come up with a tips tutorial too for this. Now, I want to show you though, I want to go and add a new calendar. And what I want to show you out of this, you can add your own sports team. So for me, I like to follow NFL football. If I go through and pick NFL, and I know the season's almost done now, but if I was going to go pick, and let's say the Houston Texans, and at this point, I can just close out now, and you'll see on this, I have a few on here. So I have that this game's coming up here, Tennessee versus Houston, and this is one I already had on. Now down below, I can go ahead and take these off as well. So just by these ellipses here, I have more options, and I can remove them from here. So just a quick tip, bonus tip for calendar. Tip four could really save yourself a big headache. Let's say you get ahead of yourself and send a message to your boss like, I'm quitting. And you go ahead and sent this, and right after you sent this, you're like, why did I do this? Well, let's rewind and show you how you can fix this. Go up to settings, go to mail, go to compose and reply, and let's move down a bit. Because what I want to show you is that you can get this back right here, undo send. So messages can be canceled up to 10 seconds. You know, if you want to make sure you have enough time, let's move it all the way to 10 and hit save. So now if you're going to send it, look at the bottom. We have 10 seconds. Change your mind, just click undo, and you'll be safe. It hasn't sent. Sticking with tip number four in sending emails, try this. If you don't want to send something right away, use the dropdown right here and schedule a send. You don't have to just hit send. You could send it tomorrow. I could pick a different day, or I could do a custom time and day, whatever works the best. Then go ahead and hit send, and that will be sent at the moment that you pick. Tip number five is about creating a professional looking email signature, and you can do this quite quickly in the new Outlook. I'm gonna go and just create a new mail. And when I do this, take a look right here. We have signature. I'm gonna drop down and put signature. Now, rather than just writing my name each time and if there's any contact information, I can go ahead and create an email signature and it'll be there every time I send. And I can say whether what type of email would I want. So let's do a little just demo here. So this is gonna be named demo. And my signature, I'll just make it really simple here. I could go through and add a lot more information. I'm just gonna give it a couple enters and I'm gonna add an image. So I could go through, add an image. When the image comes in, even if it's too large, you can do just your normal grab the corners. You can see how I can rotate and everything, just like normally when you're working with these. So if you get it to the right size that you want, notice that there's a few other format options with any fonts that you go through. Just like this, you have all those options here, and we have our format painter. Now, when you get like what you have, just go ahead and hit save. So at this point, I can add it to, is this for new messages? So I can make sure it's there, or is it for replies and forward? You can go through and save them to it. So if I go ahead and exit out of this, and I'm just gonna close this now and discard this message, notice what happens when I start a brand new mail, or message this time. So if I click on new message, there it is right here, already added to the bottom, so I can start typing. I do wanna point out though, if I go up to signature, I wanna point out a different option that you can do this to make really nice ones in a hurry. I'm gonna go over to my other account here. And if you take a look at this one here, I was able to do this in a few minutes using a program. I have a different video. I'll put a link to it. And these have different things like links you can see. So if you'd send it, you can make something like this in a hurry. So take a look at that video if you want to have a professional looking email signature. Let's move on to tip six now. Tip number six is quick steps right up here. I'm going to show you how this can save you a lot of time. Let's go ahead and make a quick step here. So if I go, just drop down on the arrow here and go to manage quick steps. This is where we can add an action that we, when we get an email, we can just click on it and it's gonna take care of it and save a number of steps. So I'm gonna go new quick step and I'm just gonna call this follow up meeting, just like this. And what's gonna be my action? So my action, notice I have a big list of different automatic quick steps that I can add to here. But what I wanna do is reply with a meeting. So we have this, we can actually add another action if we wanted to, but if you don't, you can just close that down and only keep the one. I could go through, do some customization of the quick step description, even choose a shortcut for this. I'm just gonna go ahead and hit save. Now, what you notice, when I have a message selected like this, I have it up here. If I just click on this, this automatically opens up with the window to create this meeting automatically with the email that it was attached to. So it can save me a lot of steps this way. But take a look at the other quick steps that you can add too. If you don't want to have the quick steps, you can go back and manage them again. And go ahead and just delete any of these just simply by hitting the garbage can, or you can edit them at this point too. I'm gonna give you a couple things for tip number seven. And let's say we already wrote an email here. It's not addressed to anybody, but if we wanna bring attention to somebody, we can just use the @. So if I go ahead and start applying this to somebody's, notice right away, it goes up top to the @. I can write something here, check out the notes, and then they'll bring attention to them. The other thing that I can do within an email is use the \. So if I use \, this allows me to quickly add any documents to this. So if I wanted to add a PowerPoint to this, just like this, this will be uploaded to it. Some quick ways to bring attention and do some uploads inside your emails. Tip number eight is an extremely important rule because it's going to keep your inbox clean. And that's by creating rules. let me give you an example. Notice in this case here, I have a few that I'm getting from Microsoft Viva, and I don't really want them in my inbox automatically. I can set up a rule that when they come in, they'll be organized to somewhere else, or I could even actually have them deleted, or there's a lot more options. So I have this one selected here, and I'm going to go up to rules. Now I could quickly create a rule from here. Notice that it says that it's going to take this and move it to where would I like to move it? So I could actually even create a folder from here. But I'm going to go to more options because this is where you can really drill down on the different components of it to get exactly what you want. Now I have it from Microsoft Viva. I could change the condition if I wanted here. I'm not going to change it, but I just want to point out you can have different options. Now I could even add more if it's from other people as well. I could just click in here and add more if I wanted to, and even add another condition. So you can really drill down and get exactly what you want. Now, what's my action? Well, I could have it deleted. I could have it marked as junk. All these different things I could have happen. You could have something automatically forward to someone else. I'm going to say, I just want this moved to what folder? Now, if I don't have the folder, I'm going to go ahead and create a new folder, and I'm just going to call this Viva here. So I'm going to hit save. Now I have Viva. If I look over on the left-hand side, this folder was just created. I'm going to hit save. So at this point, I haven't run my rule yet. I just have to go ahead, hit play here, run the rule now. And notice I can go back and edit the rule, or I can delete it also. So if I hit play at this point, and then I'm going to close out, and take a look at this in my inbox, they're not there anymore. Say run the rule, they went through, and if I go over to Viva here in the folder that I told it to create, they're all through here. So it can run through once you run it and take even ones from the past and clean up your email in a hurry with rules in Outlook. So I just showed you how to create a rule in the previous tip. I'm going to show you a different way you can do this to help keep your email all organized, and that's through sweep. Now I'm going to go ahead, I put these emails back in here and deleted my last rule, but I'm going to select this one and notice that we have sweep up here. So if I go ahead and select sweep, this is a quick way to make a rule. So I could go through with these quick actions right here. So this is kind of similar to what I did before. So if I click here, move all messages from the inbox folder and any future messages. And you can see the other options. So where do I want, what do I want to have happen? So if I drop down, I have my choices. I could create my new folder like I did before, or I could go down and pick the one I've already created and I can hit okay. Now this, you can see the emails on the side all disappeared and they went into that folder. If I view the rules, now this is the one I just created in here. So it automatically ran it and put it into my Viva folder that I have already here. So think about using sweep to quickly create those rules to help keep everything clean in your email. Tip number 10 is about creating groups in the new Microsoft Outlook. So rather than typing everybody's name in the to line, you can create a group that will have a name and you just have to use that name to send messages to everybody in the group. And you can even share files and everything makes it easy. So I'm going to go over to the left-hand side and I'm going to click on groups. So now at this point, I can quickly create a group right here. They're going to show up here. So if I go here, notice if I have drop down, I have a few different options. I'm going to just click on new group here. At this point, I can give it a name. So if I go and say this is for Project A, as soon as I do this, we have an email that gets created for the group. I could add a description, maybe about what the project is. I can go ahead and hit create now. Once it goes to the next, I can add some people. So I can, once I select a person, I can go through and say, what are they, owner, member, or I could even delete them. I can add multiple people here, or I could add the whole company. I can just keep adding more. You can add them later as well. So if I go hit add right now, as soon as I do this, I want to point out we have Project A. So you could have multiple groups that you're working with. So if I click on Project A, I have its own email right here. I can go through this part, I could share files within the group here. So I could go and create brand new files in here. So if I needed a new Excel workbook, I could create it from here, or I could upload documents from my computer. So we have it all in one place for great collaboration. I can see any events coming up for the group, and then I have members. At this point, notice how I can change any of these too. So I could go through and send mail from here. It's to the entire group. So if I was just going to say hello, and I'll just leave it as this, I'll say hello again, I'll hit send, I can be working in this one spot with this group. Now, I just want to point out, if I go to the edit here, looking at some of the options that I have, I can edit the group. I could go ahead and create rules to this. I can leave the group. So if I go to edit the group, if you don't want this group anymore, I can delete it here. Since I created this, I can go through and delete the group, and it's going to be gone out of there. So using groups in the new Microsoft Outlook is a great way to keep collaboration at a very high level. So now I have some bonus material tips for you. And I just want to quickly go through a few things. The first thing is that there is a search bar up here that can save you a lot of time. So if I click on this and start typing a search, it will go through my different emails and attachments and PowerPoints in here. And I have a filter that I can dive down even more, so I can be looking from a certain date or attachments. Go through and look at all the things. So if you're looking through for a certain email, make sure you take advantage of this search. Now, I just want to go to settings up here and point out a few different options to really set up your email the way you want. Now, you can add different types of accounts by just simply clicking add account. You can see I have a Gmail account here and I have a Microsoft 365, and these show over on the left-hand side over here as I expand them or open them. Now, the other thing with the accounts, if I click on the accounts, we have automatic replies. So maybe you're on a vacation. What you can do, you pick the account that you want to apply this on, you turn this on, and then I can say, maybe I know when I'm going to be gone through a certain week or so, I can set those, and you see the different options. This is where I can write my message and I save it, and it will automatically give that reply to whoever sends me a message. And now I'm just going to go down to general to show you a couple different things here. And the first one's going to be appearance. If you want to see a different theme, you can go to the dark theme. You can see how it quickly changes on here. And then we have some modern themes that you can go through and just kind of pick. You can see kind of the contrast on the different edges on everything. I'm going to hit discard again. I'm going to go back to general one more time. And I just want to point out notifications. I'm not going to go through all the things here, just some important things. Now, notifications, depending on how you want to get notified, if there's a new maybe someone mentions you in an email or sends you an email, how do you want to get notified on all these? So if you take a look and just expand this, so it's turned on, if I expand this, it will give me more options under all of these here. So when new mail, reactions, so desktop, you can see we're going to pops in, and you can go through, do you want the sound to be played? Do you want it turned off? So you can go through and set all these how you want it, so you don't have to be distracted every time a certain sound comes in or other things. So I hope you liked all these tips about the new Microsoft Outlook and how to get the most out of your email. Check out those other videos. And like I said, I'll dive into calendar a little bit more in my next tips video with Outlook. But thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.